Now, student, the next part which you are going to study of alimentary canal is esophagus. Esophagus is also known as food pipe. The length of esophagus is 25 centimeter. Now, the esophagus is divided into three regions on the basis of its location. Observe this diagram carefully. I will explain you the location of esophagus. Before that, what are the three parts of esophagus? First part is cervical, second part is thoracic, and the end part is called as abdominal. Now, by the name itself, you must have understood, students, that where does this region lie? So observe this diagram carefully. Till this region, it is called as cervical. From here till here, it is called as thoracic. And the last part, that is from here till here, it is called as abdominal region. Now, speaking about esophagus location, esophagus is located behind the trachea and heart. So it moves back or behind of trachea and heart and goes into the abdominal cavity through diaphragm. So this is all about esophagus description. Now, what is the function of esophagus? Esophagus conducts food from mouth to stomach. From pharynx to stomach, because food first enters mouth, then it goes to pharynx, then esophagus, and then stomach. So this is the function of esophagus. Next, speaking about the process, how it is carried out in esophagus. I mean, how the food is moving in esophagus. It is moving through the process called as peristaltic movement. Now, I'm drawing diagram to show peristaltic movement in esophagus. So, student, when the food passes, it enters mouth, then goes into pharynx, then the food particle coming over here, then here. What exactly happened over here? When the food is passing through the tube, it is contracting and relaxing, The rhythmic contraction and relaxation of this tube is called as peristaltic movement. This is all about esophagus, student. Thank you very much.